There are a lot of carriers out there. There's thousands of carriers every day, but every day some are going out of business and some are opening up new authorities. But how do you know which carriers are fit to move your freight? Right? It's very important when you choose carriers that you're choosing ones that are reliable, trustworthy. So because they are a reflection of you at the end of the day, and if you are doing work for your customers, they're gonna rely on you to choose carriers that can get the job done reliably. So in this video, what we're gonna cover is 5 steps to qualifying a carrier to make sure that they're gonna do a good job and to minimize the chance that anything could go wrong, right? We know nothing is perfect, but we could do our best to make sure that things go exactly the way that we want them to. So let's get right into it. The first thing that you need to do to qualify a carrier after you've located one that you potentially want to work with is to conduct a phone interview. Now, what I did is I put together a phone interview script that you should use every time that you're speaking with a carrier. That download is going to be available in the section below. And on the phone interview, you're asking general questions to kind of get a vibe of how it is to work with this carrier. How does the carrier speak with you? Are they professional? You can ask them questions like, how many trucks do you have? How long have you been in business? What kind of freight do you like to haul? What regions do you like to run? Right? You could ask them all of these things on an interview. And by the tone of that conversation, you'll get your initial impression on if you could trust this person with your customer's valuable freight, right? Because your customer's freight needs to be treated like it is your own. So it's important that you personally like the people that you're working with. So step number 2, after you have this initial phone interview, what you wanna do is you wanna verify everything that that carrier said. Now in it, if you followed my script that you could download below, you'll find that you can validate most of that information right online on a government database. It's called SaferSys, right? I'm gonna post that link below as well. And what that is that's a complete database of all of the filings of carriers and brokers. It tells you if an authority is active. It tells you how many power units they're running. It tells you their accident percentage, their out of service percentage. And then back in the day, it actually gave them a score called a CSA score. I believe they have done away with those because of some inaccuracies in the reporting. But what we always do is we look up and we verify everything that that carrier said. Is the phone number the same? Is the address the same? Are they based out of the state that they said they were? Do the area codes match? Is there a name that matches up? Is the company name accurate? How many power units do they have? You could get a complete snapshot of what those credentials look like, right? So we use that every time after a phone interview to verify what we were just told. So that's step number 2. After you have that initial interview, you have to be verifying everything that they told you. Really quick, if you are enjoying this video and you are getting any value at all, what I want you to do is I want you to scroll on down to that little button right there, hit the subscribe button so that you never miss out on any freight broker mentor updates, tips, tactics. The last thing I want you to do is fall behind in the freight broker game. It's constantly moving, constantly changing. It's important that you stay on top of things if you ever want to develop your business, right? Now, while you're at it, give this video a like. It helps more people see it, help gets the word out there, and eventually will help shape the industry for the better. Now, step number 3 is when you start the onboarding process. So after step number 3, you need to verify that they have valid insurance. Now, there's only one way to do this completely accurately, and that is to have the carrier request a certificate directly from their insurance company sent to you with you registered as the certificate holder. Now, the certificate holder doesn't do much in terms of covering you, but what it does do is it is an official document from the insurance company that validates that the party you're inquiring about does carry insurance, because you do not want to run a load on a carrier without insurance. It's just as bad as getting into an accident with somebody who doesn't have insurance, right? Because if you do that, they can't pay, your insurance has to cover everything, and if both of you don't have insurance, that could lead to a lot of big problems and lawsuits down the road, right? So we always want to verify that our carriers have insurance coverage. Limits vary based on what kind of stuff they're hauling. So we're not gonna get into that in this video, but the main thing you wanna do, make sure that carrier has insurance. After that has happened, you can move on to step number 4, which is actually onboarding this carrier by sending them your carrier package. Now, your carrier package is a contract between you and the carrier, and what it does is it outlines the terms of your agreement. Things like, how are rates determined? What happens if there's additional charges after a load's completed? How long is the agreement valid? How are claims handled? How does communication expected, right? It sets a line of expectations about your engagement with the carrier. It's very important that you have one of these, and you should not run a load with a carrier without having a proper agreement in place. We go over all these agreements and things like that in one of my private programs called the Freight Broker Accelerator. I'll put a link down below so you can check that out. If you don't have one of these in place, if something bad were to happen, it can cause a lot more problems than if you do have one, right? So it's in your best interest. Get one of these made up, find a template online that you could customize to yourself, and make sure that all your carriers are signing this. Now that we have conducted our initial interview, we validated all of the information that the carrier told us, and we verified their insurance, and we validated our relationship with a contract, the next and final step is to run a test load with them. Now, unfortunately, the only way to find out if you trust somebody is to trust them with something, right? So eventually, to start the relationship off on the right foot, you are going to have to give them a load, right? See how they do with it. When you give them a load, you want to be evaluating their communication skills, their timeliness, are they on time to pick up and delivery? Their rates, are their rates fair or are they high? You need to know this in order to quote your customers directly, right? Well, properly. Once they run that test load, you'll know right away, can I trust this carrier with my freight? Do I have to keep an eye on them? Do I want to put them on my emergency list? You'll have that understanding only after they do some actual work for you. I hope this video helped you. Make sure you are employing this process every single time that you consider adding a new carrier to your network, right? You might not have to go through every single step if the carrier is not going to move an active load for you. But the thing to remember is before they do move that load, make sure you could check off every single one of the boxes that I just mentioned. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, what I want you to do, make sure you like this video and subscribe. That'll keep you up to date on all things happening in the freight broker world. And one more thing I want you to do, if you are interested in this kind of stuff and you want a little bit more help, I want to personally invite you to join my Facebook community. It's a private community, it's called the Freight Broker Network, and it's where I hang out with all of my broker friends, where we talk shop, talk about networking with carriers, sales, rates, and industry trends that at a level that you don't really see anywhere else on the internet. So go ahead, click the Facebook link below, invite yourself in, I'll approve your request, and then you can join the conversation. Until the next video, I'll talk to you soon.